The distance between points A and B is 8 kilometers. Zen begins at point A and covers half this distance at 2 kilometers per hour. Half the distance would be 4 kilometers. And from this point to B, he travels at 4 kilometers per hour. As the total distance is 8 kilometers and this is 4 kilometers, this distance will equal 4 kilometers. So he runs half the distance at 2 kilometers per hour and the remaining half at 4 kilometers per hour. What will be his average speed? Yes, we haven't seen this concept of average speed earlier. Pause the video and try to find this average speed. It's easy. As he travels half the distance at 2 kilometers per hour and the remaining half at 4 kilometers per hour, his average speed will be 2 plus 4 over 2. This is the average of the two numbers. That will be 6 over 2 or 3 kilometers per hour. That's Zen's average speed over this distance. And as some of you might have guessed, this is a classic mistake that many students make. So what is the average speed? There is just one thing we need to understand about average speed. It equals the ratio of the total distance traveled to the total time taken to travel that distance. Yes, total distance divided by the total time. So let's see what it will be in this case. The total distance traveled is 4 plus 4 or 8 kilometers. And what is the total time taken? We haven't been given the total time taken, but can we find that out? The time taken is equal to the distance divided by the speed. And the total time taken will equal the sum of the times taken to travel each part. The time taken to travel the initial 4 kilometers will equal 4 over 2. And the time taken to travel the second part will equal 4 over 4. The sum equals the total time taken by Zen to cover the distance between points A and B. The numerator will equal 8 and the denominator will equal 2 plus 1. Zen takes 3 hours to travel from point A to point B. We get the average speed as 8 over 3. That's approximately 2.66 kilometers per hour. Wait a moment. Look at the two speeds Zen traveled at, 2 and 4 kilometers per hour. Why is the average speed closer to 2? Why isn't it closer to 4? Here's the answer. The average speed is closer to 2 kilometers per hour because Zen is traveling for more time at that speed. He is traveling at 2 kilometers per hour for 2 hours and at 4 kilometers per hour for 1 hour. If Zen would have traveled for more time at 4 kilometers per hour, the average speed would have been closer to 4 kilometers per hour and not 2 kilometers per hour. Now let's look at a new example on a new page. Zen travels at 2 kilometers per hour for half hour and then at 4 kilometers per hour for 2 hours. What will be his average speed? Pause the video and give it a shot. We just learned that the average speed equals the total distance divided by the total time taken to travel that distance. Do we have the total distance? No, but we can find that out. Yes, it will be the sum of these two distances. The product of speed and time gives us the distance. 2 multiplied by 1 half will give us this distance. And 4 times 2 will give us this distance. This sum gives us the total distance. And the total time will equal the sum of these two time durations. 1 half plus 2. This is 1 plus 8, which is 9. And the denominator will be 0.5 plus 2, which is 2.5. Let's zoom out and write the answer. We get 9 over 2.5. To solve this, we can multiply the numerator and the denominator by 4. We get 36 over 10, which equals 3.6 kilometers per hour. This, as we can see, is closer to 4 kilometers per hour. It's closer to 4 kilometers per hour because he's traveling for more time at that speed. Let's look at one last problem to understand average speed. Zen travels at 3 kilometers per hour for 6 kilometers and 5 kilometers per hour for 10 kilometers. What will be his average speed? Pause the video and solve this one. The average speed is the ratio of the total distance to the total time taken to travel that distance. The total distance will be 6 plus 10. What will be the total time? It will be the sum of the time durations for each of these parts. The time taken to cover this part will equal 6 over 3 or 2 hours. And the time taken to travel this part will equal 10 over 5 or 2 hours. So the total time will equal 2 plus 2 or 4 hours. That will equal 16 over 4. 4 kilometers per hour. Is this closer to 3 or to 5? It's equidistant from each. And why is that? It's because he's traveling for the same time at each of the speeds. Hence, this is the average of the individual speed rates. We will look at more examples of average speed over the next few sessions.